This is the second part of this video series about CrowdSim 3D. This part will show you how to add agents to your scene and how to populate them. You can add agents to your scene via the Add menu. In the submenu CrowdSim, you find various ways how to add agents to your scene. When selecting agent, a single agent will be added to your scene. After we added an agent, we can duplicate the agent just like a regular Blender object. An agent is drawn as an arrow. The point of the arrow shows the facing direction of the agent. You can also add agents in a formation. For this, we select Agents. An agent factory is added. In the Object tab, you will find a CrowdSim panel with various options. We can set the number of agents. The direction the agent should be facing. And change the randomness. There are several distribution patterns. By default, the grid distribution pattern is used. The grid distribution pattern places the agents in a column-row type of pattern. We can change the pattern to random or quincunx. There are also several types of distributions. Now we use the plane distribution. We can select the circle distribution to place the agents in a circle. Notice that the agents are still in the same pattern, but no agents are added outside the circle. The triangle distribution places the agents inside the triangle. You can rotate, scale, or move the factory to the place you want the agents to appear. The grid distribution places the agents in columns and rows. The difference with the grid distribution pattern is that you can set the number of columns and rows. The last distribution type allows you to place agents within the contours of a mesh. For this, let's add a mesh. I added a plane and use Extrude to build a floor plan. Remember the mesh name. Here it is plane 001. We select the factory and select the mesh we added. Now the agents are placed inside the mesh. We can change the orientation to the right location. When using mesh distribution, only the random pattern is possible. We have seen how to add multiple agents. Now let's populate the robot we configured in the first video to these agents. We link in the node tree that contains the configuration of our robot. You don't need to import the armature or the objects at all. They are connected to the configuration and loaded automatically. This makes it easy to update the configuration and just reload your scene to get the new meshes and variables. We add some agents to the scene. Here, I use the grid distribution and make a grid of 10 by 10 agents. Setting the model, character and material variable per agent can be a tedious job. What we want to show you is how to create a node tree that can do this for us. We add a CrowdSim node tree. In the node category called Populate, you find various nodes that help you to automate this task. We start by adding a Populate node and select the model we want to populate, the robot. Now we add a mesh variable node. This node needs to be connected to the Populate node to determine the settings to show. When connected, you see the character and the options for the weighted mesh groups of the robot. The slider is the weight that is used for selecting that option. After clicking Populate Agents, all the agents in the scene are populated. We can change the weight to get a different distribution. When setting a weight to 0, this option will never be chosen. And all our agents will become pulleys. After you have populated the agents, it is still possible to change the settings manually. With the material variable node, you can variate the materials. You connect the node to the populate node and tick the material variable you want to variate. You can set the minimum and maximum value you want to variate between. When finished, you can click the populate agents again and see the new population of the agents. But what if you have two crowds in the same scene and you want to make the first crowd the police and the other crowd the thief character? In this scene, we started with two agent factories. We add a populate node and a mesh variable node and connect them. We set the slider for the thief to 0, as we only want the police character to be chosen. With the object selector node, we can select the agents that we want the populate node to work on. When you do not have an object selector node connected, the populate node will automatically select all the agents in the scene. We select only agents that are generated from the police factory. You see that only one group of agents are populated and only with the police character. We do the same for the other crowd. You can duplicate the nodes we already created for a faster workflow. You now have two crowds automatically populated with two different populations. This is the end of this video. In the next video, we will show how to bring your agents to life.